A shocking new report from the Daily Beast came out this week saying that Donald Trump openly mocked Georgia Republican officials after they talked about the fact that they have been getting death threats from his supporters. Here's what happened. January 2nd, Donald Trump makes a call to Georgia Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger saying, go find the votes, go find those 11,000 plus votes so that I can win your state and everything is great. Raffensperger said, no, I'm not going to do that. And shortly afterward, that's when Raffensperger and his wife, Tricia, began receiving death threats. In fact, Tricia received a text message in April from crazed Trump supporters that said, you and your family will be killed very slowly. We plan for the death of you and your family every day. That was in April. It was months after Raffensperger did not decide to throw the election for Donald Trump. And according to this new report from the Daily Beast, Trump, who was still in the White House when most of the death threats, when he was made aware of the death threats coming in, a former administration official said this. There was this one time I heard Trump suggest they might be exaggerating the kind of threats they were getting, but more often he'd make fun of them and say they were bad people who were getting what they deserved. Trump also heaped praise on those making the threats, calling them, quote, my people. He praised the people threatening to kill Brad Raffensperger, called them my people, and then he mocked Raffensperger and every other probably election official in this country. Because if you'll think back, at that time, we were getting reports of election workers, poll workers, just regular everyday people who go and they work the polls on election day. They were all getting death threats across the country from angry, deranged Trump supporters. And he was mocking them. He thought it was funny. Thought it was a jovial matter. This man is absolutely psychotic. And I mean that in my personal opinion, in every sense of the word. This man is psychotic. At the very least, a little sadistic, right? He seems to delight in the pain of others. It brings him great joy when humans are suffering. Republicans, this is your guy. This is who you've chosen to hitch your entire party to. This is what you have become. This is who you are, and there is no escaping that identity at this point. Every single one of you, whether you're just your average card-carrying Republican walking to work right now, or an elected official fighting for your life in a re-election bid, all of you owned this. You own this man. You own his words. You own his actions. You cannot attempt to divorce yourself from this anymore. And yes, that even goes for people like Adam Kinzinger and Liz Cheney, those never Trump Republicans. Well, guess what? As long as you cling to this party and the party clings to Trump, you own this as well. You may outwardly say that you don't like it, that you don't want any part of it, but you're staying a part of it. You made your choice. And this disgusting freak of a human being is what your party chose. So by staying with the party, you're tacitly condoning this. If you can't get enough Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to subscribe to our channel for fresh video content 7 days a week. And for even more from me, you can follow me on all social media outlets, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Farron Balanced.